हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू मयंक लोहालिक। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन पेपर ऑफ यूपी एपीओ 2015। एज यू माइट बी अवेयर दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द यूपी एपीओ पेपर ऑफ 2020। इफ यू हैव नॉट वॉच दिस वीडियो देन प्लीज गो टू द डिस्क्रिप्शन सेक्शन, अ लिंक ऑफ 2020 पेपर विल बी गिवन ओवर देयर। सो लेट अस गेट स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर वन। टू हुम अमंग द फॉलोइंग विल द लोकायुक्त ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश एड्रेस इज रेजिग्नेशन लेटर। ऑप्शन आर चीफ मिनिस्टर ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश, गवर्नर ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश, चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ हाई कोर्ट, स्पीकर ऑफ विधानसभा। करेक्ट आंसर इज गवर्नर ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश। लोकायुक्त विल गिव इज रेजिग्नेशन टू गवर्नर ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश। नाउ प्रोसीड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर टू। अकॉर्डिंग टू द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया विच वन द फॉलोइंग इज सुप्रीम, द प्रेसिडेंट, द सुप्रीम कोर्ट, द पार्लियामेंट, द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। करेक्ट आंसर इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन। कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया इज द सुप्रीम अमंग द फॉलोइंग। नाउ लेट अस प्रोसीड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री। In India, Prime Minister is elected, selected, nominated, appointed. Correct answer is option D, that is appointed. Question number 4. According to the Constitution of India, which among the following is empowered to establish new states? Options are President, Parliament, Supreme Court, Cabinet. Parliament is empowered to establish new states. Question number 5. In which year the two words socialist and secular were added to the preamble of the Indian Constitution? Year options are 1976, 1977, 1978, 1979. Correct answer is option A, that is 1976 in 42nd Amendment Act. Question number 6. The Renaissance is based on which of the following concepts? God is the center of universe, Pope is the center of universe, man is the center of universe, none of the above. Correct answer is option C, that is man is the center of universe. The word Renaissance is related to the world history. Question number 7. Who among the following first used the word Renaissance? Options are Michelet, Dante, Thomas Aquinas, Kant. Correct answer is option A, that is Michelet. Question number 8. Who among the following first used the word Swaraj? Options are Mahatma Gandhi, Dada Bhai Nauroji, Bal Gangadhar Tilak, Gopal Krishna Gokhale. Correct answer is option B, that is Dada Bhai Nauroji. Swaraj was first used by Dada Bhai Nauroji in his presidential address at Calcutta session in 1906. Dada Bhai Nauroji has used the word first time Swaraj in Calcutta session of 1906. Now let us move to question number 9. The Moti Masjid in Agra was built during whose reign? Himayu, Shahjahan, Aurangzeb, Shah Alam II. Correct answer is Shahjahan. Moti Masjid of Agra was built during the reign of Shahjahan. Question number 10. Who among the following was the first Indian to get selected in ICS, Indian Civil Services? Options are Satyendranath Tagore, Sarojini Naidu, Lala Lajpat Rai, C.R. Das. Correct answer is Satyendranath Tagore. Satyendranath Tagore was India's first ICS to get selected in the Indian Civil Services. Question number 11. Who among the following gave the slogan Inqilab Zindabad? Options are Iqbal, M.K. Gandhi, Bhagat Singh, Subhash Chandra Bose. Correct answer is Bhagat Singh. Bhagat Singh gave the slogan Inqilab Zindabad. Question number 12. The newspaper brought out by Bal Gangadhar Tilak to promote nationalism was? Options are Yugantar, Kesari, Deshbhakti, Kranti. Correct answer is Kesari. Kesari and Maratha, two newspapers was published by Bal Gangadhar Tilak to promote nationalism. Question number 13. The first Governor General of India was appointed in 1774, 1833, 1858, 1911. Correct answer is option A, that is 1774. The first Governor General of India was appointed. Question number 14. The word Satyagraha was given by Mahatma Gandhi, Mangal Lal Gandhi, Devdas Gandhi, Kasturba Gandhi. This is a very tricky question. Most of the people will think that Mahatma Gandhi will be the correct answer, but here the correct answer Mangal Lal Gandhi. This term Satyagraha was originated in competition in the New Sheet of Indian Opinion, that was the newspaper in South Africa in 1906. Mr. Mangal Lal Gandhi, grandson of an uncle of Mahatma Gandhi, came up with the word. Earlier it was the word Satyagraha. Gandhi ji changed this word in Indian Opinion in his newspaper as Satyagraha. So it was firstly used by Mangal Lal Gandhi, then it was used by Mahatma Gandhi. Question number 15. Who among the following was the president of Indian National Congress on 15th August 1947? This is a very important question. Correct answer is J.B. Kriplani. When in free India, the first president of Congress was J.B. Kriplani. Question number 16. Gadar newspaper was published from France, Germany, America, England. Option is C, America. Gadar was an organization which published newspaper in San Francisco, America. Question number 17. Who among the following is not a public document? Options are arrest warrant, charge sheet, postmortem report, a registered sale deed. Not a public document, postmortem report is not a public document. Question number 18. Who among the following has recently appointed as new CVC commissioner? Options are Bhaseen, K.V. Chaudhary, Pradeep Kumar, none of the above. Correct answer is K.V. Chaudhary. Question number 19. In which of the following jails Rajinder Lahiri was hanged? Options are Faizabad, Gorakhpur, Gonda, Lucknow. Correct answer is ऑप्शन सी दैट इज गोंडा. क्वेश्चन नंबर 20, विच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज नॉट मेंशन्ड इन ऋग्वेद. जनपद, जन, ग्राम, कुल. करेक्ट आंसर इज जनपद. जनपद इज नॉट मेंशन्ड इन ऋग्वेद. अदर थ्री ऑप्शन दैट इज जन, कुल एंड ग्राम आर मेंशन्ड इन द ऋग्वेद. क्वेश्चन नंबर 21, हु अमंग द फॉलोइंग एडेड टू द डॉक्ट्रिन ब्रह्मचर्य इन जैनिज्म. ऑप्शन आर परशुनाथ, नेमिनाथ, महावीर, नन ऑफ देव. करेक्ट आंसर इज महावीर. महावीर was the Jain guru who added the doctrine of Brahmacharya in Jainism. Question number 22, who among the following rishis composed the Gayatri Mantra? Correct answer is Vishwamitra. Rishi Vishwamitra composed the Gayatri Mantra. Question number 23, who among the following Indian mathematicians invented metric system? Options are Aryabhatta, Pingal, Gargi, Bhaskar. Correct answer is Pingal. Pingal invented the metric system in Indian mathematics. Question number 24, in which one of the following countries the 16th World Sanskrit Conference was held? Options are Nepal, Thailand, Bhutan, Bahrain. Correct answer is Thailand. This question is asking about the 16th World Sanskrit Conference. The 18th World Sanskrit Conference will held in 2023 in January in Canberra, Australia. In 1972, Delhi, first World Sanskrit Conference was held. Last Sanskrit Conference was held in Vancouver, Canada in 2018. So next will be held in 2023. It is important to know, if this question get repeated in the exam, then you have to know that in 2018 World Sanskrit Conference was held in Canada, and in 2023 it will held in Canberra, Australia. Question number 25, which one of the following countries has recently decided to discard its virtually worthless national currency? Options are South Africa, Kenya, Sudan, Zimbabwe. Correct answer is Zimbabwe. Question number 26, which of the following was the host country of the World Environment Day 2015? Options are Brazil, Italy, China, Australia. Correct answer is Italy. There is one thing you need to know, that World Environment Day every year is celebrated on 5th of June. Host country for 2021 was Pakistan for 2021, and for 2022 it will be Sweden. And of 5th June, World Environment Day is celebrated. Question number 27, the first stem cell bank of India has been opened in. Correct answer is Chennai. Question number 28, according to the finance ministry, which one of the following state has the highest per capita debt? Correct answer is option A, that is Goa. Question number 29, according to the Global Peace Index 2015, which of the following is the least peaceful country? Options are Egypt, Pakistan, Iraq, Syria. Correct answer is Syria. In 2015 index, correct answer was Syria. Global Peace Index is a report published by Institute for Economics and Peace, IEP. The Global Peace Index ranks 172 independent states and territories. In 2021, Iceland got the rank 1 in Global Peace Index, and India got the 135th rank in Global Peace Index, whereas the last rank was given to Afghanistan. As you all are aware, the changes, the political changes that has taken to Afghanistan, because of which the Afghanistan got the last rank, that is 163 rank. Question number 30, according to the Global Peace Index 2015, which one of the following is the most peaceful country? Options are Brazil, Denmark, Iceland, Ireland. Correct answer is Iceland. In 2015 also Iceland was the correct answer. Now in 2021 also the most peaceful country in the world is Iceland. So it is definitely a great progress by Iceland. Question number 31, who among the following has launched the India's first air conditioner demo train in Kochi? Options are Prime Minister, Railway Minister, Chief Minister of Kerala, Science and Technology Minister. Correct answer is Railway Minister. Question number 32, which airport will be the first in India to get ground-based augmentation system? Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Chennai, Varanasi. Correct answer is Ahmedabad Airport. Ahmedabad Airport got the first ground-based augmentation system. Question number 33, which one of the following typhoons hit South China's Henan province? Options are Katrina, Hudhud, Kujira, Phailin. Correct answer is Kujira. Question number 34, the full form of ISRO is Indian Space Research Organization. This is the correct answer. Question number 35, MICAS is a new technique used for. Options are angioplasty, bypass surgery, knee replacement surgery, brain surgery. Correct answer is bypass surgery. Question number 36, which one of the following disease is caused by virus? Options are diphtheria, malaria, cholera, hepatitis. Correct answer is hepatitis. Hepatitis is caused by the virus. From science section, virus has been asked, and you are aware that already COVID-19 pandemic has gone through. So there might be chances if from science section related to COVID-19 vaccine or COVID-19 variants, virus questions can be asked. So it will be important for your current affairs section. Question number 37. Which of the following is known as red planet? Correct answer is Mars. Mars is known as a red planet. Question number 38. Till June 2015, how many times the nuclear weapon have been used in warfare? Correct answer is 2. Nuclear weapon has been used in warfare in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Question number 39. Which one of the following is called white gold? Options are mercury, platinum, petroleum, none of the above. Correct answer is platinum. Platinum is also known as the white gold. Question number 40. Which one of the following substance is the richest source of vitamin A? Yeast, cheese, golden rice, orange. Golden rice is the richest source of vitamin A. Question number 41. Which one of the following compounds does not occur in tea leaves? Options are atropine, theine, theobromine, thelophylline. Correct answer is atropine. Atropine are the compounds which does not occur in tea leaves. Question number 42. Who among the following is often described as the father of Indian IT sector? Options are N.R. Narayan Murthy, Tata Jamshedji, Lalit Modi, none of the above. N.R. Narayan Murthy is known as the father of Indian IT sector. His company is Infosys. Question number 43. Which one of the following countries is the second largest country in the world in terms of geographical area? Options are China, Canada, Australia, United States. Correct answer is Canada. A simple trick to remember the geographical areas, the largest country and the smallest country. Code is there which you can remember, that is RACCUBAI, RCCUBAI. This is a simple code you can remember by which you can easily guess the geographical area. R stands for Russia, C stands for Canada, another C stands for China, and U stands for USA. So the top four countries according to geographical area is Russia, Canada, China, and USA. And then B stands for Brazil, A stands for Australia, and then I stands for India. India is the seventh largest country in geographical area. Question number 44. Which one among the following countries had the largest population in 2014? Options are Russian Federation, Bangladesh, Japan, Mexico. Correct answer is Bangladesh. Question number 45. Aswan High Dam has been built on which of the following rivers? Options are Columbia River, Danube River, Nile River, Irrawaddy River. Correct answer is Nile River. Question number 46. The largest island of the world in area is Coco, Madagascar, Green Island, Sentry. Correct answer is Green Island. Greenland is the largest island of the world in area. Question number 47. The largest gold producing country in the world in 2011 is? Options are USA, Australia, China, South Africa. Correct answer is option C, that is China. In 2021 also, China's mines produced an estimated 370 metric tons of gold. So not only in 2011 but also in 2021 also, the largest gold producing country is China. Question number 48. In which of the following Indian states does not form border with Bangladesh? This is very important question. Options are Assam, Meghalaya, Manipur, Tripura. Correct answer is Manipur. Manipur does not form border with Bangladesh in northeastern states. Assam form the border with Bangladesh, Meghalaya as well as Tripura also form border with the Bangladesh. Question number 49. The largest coffee producing country of the world in 2013 is Ethiopia, Mexico, Vietnam, Brazil. Correct answer is Brazil. In 2021 also, correct answer is Brazil. Brazil produced around 40% of the world supply of coffee. Question number 15. A judge of Supreme Court may resign his office by writing a letter to, this is very easy question, by the president. A judge can resign by writing a letter to the president. Question number 51. The revenue system of Akbar's reign was in the hands of, this is also a very easy question, Todarmal. Todarmal was one of the nine gems of Akbar's kingdom, and he used to have the great knowledge about the revenue system. Question number 52. Under Evidence Act, the value of medical evidence is only corroborative, is conclusive, is of no assistant, is conclusive even if contrary to credible and trustworthy evidence of eyewitness. Correct answer is only corroborative. Under the Evidence Act, the value of medical evidence is only corroborative. Question number 53. Which one of the following section of Indian Evidence Act gives effect to the principle that possession is the prima facie evidence of a complete title? Options are section 110, section 112, section 113, section 114. Correct answer is section 110. Section 110 of Indian Evidence Act talks about the burden of proof as to ownership. When the question is whether any person is the owner of anything of which he is shown to be in possession, then the burden of proof that he is not the owner is on the person who affirms that he is not the owner. Now let us proceed to question number 54. A dying declaration can be oral, in writing, in any adequate method of communication, all of the above. Correct answer is option D, that is all of the above. Question number 55. A plea of alibi is a special exception under IPC, is a general exception under IPC, is only a rule of evidence recognized in section 11 of Evidence Act, none of the above. Correct answer is option C, that is only a rule of evidence recognized in section 11 of Evidence Act. Question number 56. Which section of Indian Evidence Act makes the provision that there shall be no new trial on the ground of improper admission or rejection of evidence? Options are section 166, 165, 167, 166. Section 167 of Indian Evidence Act. Section 167 of Indian Evidence Act says that no new trial for improper admission, rejection of evidence. Now let us proceed to question number 57. Which one of the following section of Indian Evidence Act provides provisions relating to refreshing memory? Correct answer is section 159. Section 159 talks about the refreshing memory. So, a witness may, while under examination, refresh his memory by refreshing to any writing by himself at the time of the transaction concerning which he is questioned, or so soon afterwards that the court considers it likely that the translation was at the time fresh in his memory. Now, let us proceed to question number 58. Which section of Indian Evidence Act provides that no particular number of witness shall in any case be required for the proof of any fact? Options are section 135, 134, 136, 132. Correct answer is section 134. Question number 59. Under which section of Evidence Act, continuous cohabitation for a number of years may raise the presumption of marriage? Options are section 112, section 150, section 114, none of the above. Correct answer is section 50. Question number 60. Who can make an admission under Indian Evidence Act? Person from whom the interest derived, an independent person witness to a proceeding that court. Here the correct answer is person from whom the interest is derived can make an admission under the Indian Evidence Act. Now question number 61. Presumption of life is contained in which of the following section of Indian Evidence Act? Presumption of life is contained in section 107 of the Indian Evidence Act. Question number 62. For an offence under section 376 IPC, evidence of character of the victim is not relevant under which section of Evidence Act? Correct answer is section 53A. Section 53A, the evidence of character of the victim is not relevant. Question number 63. Which section of Evidence Act deals with the rule of res justi? This is very important question and it has been asked in many examination. You must be aware of this answer, that is section 6. Section 6 is related to res justi. Question number 64. Electronic records were included in section 3 of the Evidence Act with the effect from? Correct answer is 17th October 2000. Electronic records were included in section 3 of Evidence Act. Question number 65. Match list first and list second and select the correct answer using the quotes given below. Document. Document is given under section 3 of Indian Evidence Act. Primary evidence. Primary evidence is given under section 62 of Indian Evidence Act. Secondary evidence. Secondary evidence is given under section 63 of Evidence Act. And oral evidence is provided in section 60 of Indian Evidence Act. So, by going through these options, correct answer is option B, 1, 2, 3 and 4. Question number 66. A accused of theft on the occasion of and causing grievous hurt to another occasion. A must be charged separately for the theft and for causing grievous hurt. Charged jointly for theft and causing grievous hurt. Tried jointly for theft and for causing grievous hurt. Charged jointly for theft and for causing grievous hurt, but tried separately for those two offenses. Here the correct answer is option A, that is charged separately for theft and for causing grievous hurt. Question number 67. Warrant case means a case relating to an offense. Options are punishable with death, punishable with imprisonment for life, or punishment for a term exceeding 2 years. Punishment with imprisonment not exceeding 2 years. A and B above. Here the correct answer is A and B above. Punishment with death and punishment with imprisonment for life or imprisonment for a term exceeding 2 years will be known as warrant case. Question number 68. Children of Muslim parents are not entitled to maintenance under section 125 CRPC, not entitled to maintenance under section 125 CRPC if living with divorced wife, entitled to maintenance not governed by CRPC. Correct answer is CRPC. Section 125 of CRPC gave right to children of Muslim parents also to entitled to have maintenance. Question number 69. FIR is only a report about the commission of a crime. FIR in itself is a substantial evidence. Options are 1 is true but 2 is false. Yes, this is the correct option, that FIR is only a report about the commission of crime. FIR in itself is a substantial evidence. No, FIR is not in itself a substantial evidence, but it is only a report about the commission of the offense. Therefore, the option A will be the correct option. Question number 70. R.M. Malkani versus State of Maharashtra, AIR 1973, deals with the admissibility of, correct answer is tape recorded evidence. This is very important question. It has also been asked in various examination. And you should remember the case law. R.M. Malkani versus State of Maharashtra, 1973, deals with the admissibility of the tape recorded evidence. Question number 71. X is charged with for promoting enmity between two groups on the ground of language. Whose previous sanction is required before a court to take the cognizance of this offence under CRPC? Correct answer is central government or state government. Question number 72. Under which section of CRPC court has discretionary power to summon any person as a witness? Options are section 311, section 319, section 311A, section 313. Correct answer is section 311. Now let us know something about the section 311 of CRPC, which give power to the court, discretionary power to summon any person as a witness. Section 311 says that power to summon material witness or examine person present. Any court may at any stage of any inquiry, trial or other proceeding under this code, under CRPC, summon any person as a witness or examine any person in attendance, though not summoned as a witness, or recall and re-examine any person already examined. And the court shall summon and examine or recall the and re-examine any such person if his evidence appear it to be the unessential for the just decision of the case. So therefore, you have to remember the section 311, which gives the discretionary power to the court to summon any person as a witness. Now let us proceed to question number 73. Facts alleged by one party and denied by other in a case is termed as facts in issue. Section 112 of the Indian Evidence Act creates a legal friction. It does not provide for presumption. Provides for conclusive presumption which can be rebutted by DNA test. Provides for conclusive test not rebuttable in any case. Correct answer is option C. That is, provides for conclusive presumption which can be rebutted by DNA test. Question number 75. A is accused of the murder of B. At his trial, which of the following facts may be an issue? A caused B's death. A is an honest person. A has received a grave and sudden provocation from B. A was awarded for social services. Here the correct answer will be A is caused of B's death is relevant. And then A had received grave and sudden provocation of B. This is also relevant because A is accused of the murder of B. A is an honest person. This talks about a character which is not relevant. A was awarded for social service. This is also the character. This is also not relevant. So option 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. In the given options, B, that is 1 and 3 will be the right answer. Question number 76. Case of Sharad Chandra De versus Gopal Chandra Laha is concerned with confession, conspiracy, presumption, estoppel. Correct answer is estoppel. Question number 77. A witness unable to speak given evidence by sign gestures in open court. Such evidence is oral evidence, secondary evidence, special evidence, circumstantial evidence. Correct answer is oral evidence. Question number 78. In which of the following cases the constitutional validity of section 27 of the Indian Evidence Act was challenged on the basis of being violative of article 20 clause 3 of the Indian Constitution? Options are State of UP versus Devman Upadhyay, State of Bombay versus Katbi Kalu, Inayatullah versus State of Maharashtra and Nandini Satpati versus PL Dhani. Here the correct answer is option C, that is Inayatullah versus State of Maharashtra. Number 79. Under section 45 of the Evidence Act, the opinion of expert cannot be sought for foreign law, science of art, Indian law, finger impressions. Correct answer is Indian law. Question number 80. Proviso to section 132, Indian Evidence Act 1872 is a facet of rule against self-incrimination. Reason, policy of section 132, Indian Evidence Act is to procure evidence for doing justice. Select the correct answer from the code given below. By reading the options, it is clear that both A and R are true and R is the correct explanation of A. Question number 81. A police officer is bound to register an FIR. Upon receiving any information relating to commission of a cognizable offence under section 154 of CRPC, it was observed by the Supreme Court in the case of Lalita Kumari versus State of UP. This is the landmark judgment and you must have to read this judgment. So the correct answer is option A, that is Lalita Kumari versus State of UP. In this case, a police officer is bound to register an FIR upon receiving of any information relating to commission of cognizable offence. Now let us proceed to question number 82. When the officer in charge of the police station receives information that a person has committed suicide, he will be immediately report to the judicial magistrate, executive magistrate, chief judicial magistrate, high court. Correct answer is executive magistrate. Question number 83. Which of the following section of CRPC provides for recording remarks respecting demeanors of witness? Options are section 288, section 280, section 278, section 270. Here the correct answer is option B, that is section 280. Question number 84. Who can issue a search warrant to search a post office? Correct answer is district magistrate. Question number 85. Jurisdiction grant anticipatory bail vest with chief judicial magistrate, the court of session, high court, both B and C. Correct answer is option D, that is both and C. Anticipatory bail can be given by the court of session and the high court. Question number 86. Under the criminal procedure code, legal protection has been provided to an accused who is of unsound mind. The provisions finds place in section 328, section 331, section 334, all of the above. Correct answer is option D, that is all of the above. In CRPC, section 328 talks about the procedure in case of an accused being lunatic, and section 331 talk about the resumption of inquiry and trial. This is also included in section 328 itself. Section 334 is related to the judgment of acquittal on ground of unsoundness of mind. So these all three sections are related to the unsoundness of mind. Therefore, option D is the correct answer. Question number 87. Which one of the following sections of CRPC contains law relating to compensatory justice? Options are section 355, section 356, section 357, section 359. Correct answer is section 357. Section 357 is relating to the law relating to compensatory justice. Question number 88. Public prosecutor under section 2U of the CRPC means includes any person appointed under section 24 of the Code of Criminal Procedure, any person acting under the direction of a public prosecutor, both A and B, none of the above. Here the correct answer is option D, that is none of the above. Question number 89. In which one of the following section of CRPC provision for the treatment of victim has been made? Correct answer is section 357C. In section 357C of CRPC, the provisions for the treatment of victims has been made. Question number 90. Cognizance of an offense of defamation under chapter 21 of IPC can be taken on a police report, on a complaint made by an aggrieved person, sumo to by court, all of the above. Here the correct answer is on a complaint made by an aggrieved person, the offense of defamation under chapter 25 of IPC, cognizance can be taken. Now let us proceed to question number 91. Provisions relating to plea bargaining is applicable to offenses affecting the socio-economic conditions of India, offenses committed against women, offenses against children below 14 years, none of the above. In this question, the options which are given are not correct. Therefore, the option D will be the right answer. That is none of the above. Question number 92. A judicial magistrate may record confession in the course of trial, in the course of inquiry, in the course of investigation, all of the above. A judicial magistrate may record confession in the course of investigation. Option C will be the right answer. Question number 93. Which section of CRPC resembles with the writ of habeas corpus? Correct answer is section 97. Section 97 resembles with the writ of habeas corpus, which says that in 24 hours the accused has to be presented in front of the magistrate. Question number 94. Which one of the following section of CRPC deals with the prosecution to offenses against marriage? Options are section 198, section 199, section 197, none of the above. Correct answer is section 198. Question number 195. Which one of the following remedies have not been provided under the criminal procedure code? Options are reference, review, revision, appeal. Correct answer is option B, that is review. Question number 96. A is an accused of theft. After arrest, remained 90 days in preventive detention. After this, he was imprisoned for 1 year. Is he entitled for a set-off of 90 days? Yes, he will be entitled for the set-off of 90 days. Question number 97. If a presiding judge of a court fails to sign and date of the judgment, it will amount to procedural irregularity curable under section 465 clause 1 of CRPC. Question number 98. Under section 145 of CRPC, in disputes as to immovable property, the executive magistrate can decide the question of possession and title, actual possession, title, all of the above. Executive magistrate can decide the question of actual possession. Question number 99. Court of Justice is defined in IPC in section 20. In section 20, Court of Justice is defined in IPC. And in section 21, public servant is defined in IPC. Question number 100. Under which of the following section of IPC, rash and negligent driving of the vehicle on the public way is an offense? Correct answer is section 279. Question number 101. Dishonest misappropriation of property is an offense against movable property. Yes, dishonest appropriation of property is an offense against movable property. This is the correct answer. Question number 102. A obtained a sum of rupees 10,000 from B by putting B in fear of death, which one of the following offenses was committed by A? A has committed the offense of extortion under IPC. You have to match the offense with the sections of IPC. Criminal conspiracy is defined in section 120A of IPC, and attempt to murder is defined in section 307 of IPC. Culpable homicide is provided under section 299 of IPC, and extortion is given in section 383 of IPC. Therefore, the correct answer will be option A. Question number 104. Which one of the following section of IPC applies the maxim ignorance of law is no excuse? Correct answer is section 79. Section 79 of IPC talks about that ignorance of law is no excuse. Question number 105. Which section of the Police Act deals with the power of district superintendent of police to regulate the volume of music on the roads on the occasion of festivals? Options are section 15A clause 4, section 27 clause 2, section 30 clause 4, section 16 clause 3. Correct answer is section 13 clause 4. Question number 106. Which one of the following is not correctly matched as per the UP police regulations? Option A, Armed Police Chapter 6, this is the correct match. Mounted Police Chapter 8, this is also the correct match. Village Police Chapter 9 is also the correct match. Whereas Investigation, that is here it is given Chapter 10, is not the correct match. Therefore, the D option is the correct answer. Question number 107. Which one of the following sections deals with the power of Special Police Officer under the Police Act 1861? Options are Section 17, Section 18, Section 19, Section 20. Here the correct answer is section 18. In section 18, the power of special police officer is given in Police Act 1861. Question number 108. Which one of the following paras of police regulations provide that it is the personal duty of the police thana in charge not to keep a person of unsound mind in the same cell with other persons? Options are para 160, para 161, para 162, para 163. Here the correct answer is para 161. Question number 109. Police officer will take the unclaimed property, that is the property of which the owner is not known, into his possession, but for its disposal whose orders are to be taken in consideration for the guidance? Correct answer is district magistrate guidance and consideration has to be taken while taking the proclamation of unclaimed property. Question number 110. Who among the following officers can order for the conduct of public gathering, public movement on a public road, lenses and roads? Correct answer is Superintendent of Police. Question number 111. Under Section 15 Clause 3 of Police Act, dealing with disturbed or troubled areas, the cost of additional police force shall be borne by resident of the area. This question has been repeatedly asked, so you have to read this answer thoroughly. Question number 112. Who among the following will appoint head constable in armed police through the promotion from constables of the district police force? This question has also been asked, that is Superintendent of Police will be the correct answer. Question number 113. In which of the following paras of UP police regulations it has been laid down that the constables of the civil police shall not be armed except on the special occasions? Options are para 58, para 59, para 61, para 63. Correct answer is para 61. Para 61 talks about that under UP police regulations it has been laid down that constables of the civil police will not be armed, exception is special occasions. Question number 140. After examination of any injury or after death, the medical officer will prepare a report in 2 copies, 3 copies, 4 copies, such number as demanded by relative of the victim. Correct answer is 3 copies. Question number 115. Who is the officer in charge of a police station, thana? Among the following, head constable is not the in charge, assistant sub inspector of police is also not the in charge, sub inspector of police is the in charge. Question number 116. Which one of the following is not included within the meaning of animal under Police Act? Dog, sheep, goat, all of the above. Dog is not included in the meaning of animal under the Police Act 1861, whereas sheep, goat, horses are included in the animal section in Police Act. Sentences which Chief Judicial Magistrate may pass. Options are sentence to death, sentence for life, imprisonment for a term exceeding 7 years, imprisonment for a term less than 7 years. Correct answer is option D, that is imprisonment for a term less than 7 years. This is the power given by CGM, that sentence, he can pass the sentence of imprisonment for a term less than 7 years. Question number 118. Under the UP police regulations, a village chowkidar is responsible to. Village chowkidar is responsible to district magistrate. This is the correct answer. This question has been repeatedly asked in the APU examination, and this is also a very important question. क्वेश्चन नंबर 119 सेक्शन 7 ऑफ द पुलिस एक्ट 1861 इज रिलेटेड टू डिपार्टमेंटल एक्शन जुडिशियल एक्शन बोथ ए एंड बी नन ऑफ द अबव सेक्शन 7 ऑफ द यूपी पुलिस एक्ट इज रिलेटेड टू डिपार्टमेंटल एक्शन क्वेश्चन नंबर 120 व्हिच वन ऑफ द फॉलोइंग सेक्शन ऑफ यूपी पुलिस एक्ट 1861 प्रोवाइड्स दैट अ पुलिस ऑफिसर इज ऑलवेज ऑन ड्यूटी एंड मे बी डिप्लॉयड इन एनी पार्ट ऑफ द जनरल पुलिस डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑप्शन आर सेक्शन 20 सेक्शन 21 सेक्शन 22 सेक्शन 23 करेक्ट आंसर इज सेक्शन 22 सेक्शन 22 सजेस्ट दैट द अंडर पुलिस एक्ट 1861 पुलिस ऑफिसर इज ऑलवेज ऑन ड्यूटी एंड मे बी डिप्लॉयड इन एनी पार्ट ऑफ द जनरल पुलिस डिस्ट्रिक्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 121 एक्स हैविंग अ सफिशियंट फूड डज नॉट प्रोवाइड सम फूड टू अ बेगर हु डाइज ऑफ हंगर एक्स इज गिल्टी ऑफ एक्स विल बी गिल्टी ऑफ नो ऑफेंस क्वेश्चन नंबर 122 एक्स ऑन रिसीविंग ग्रेव एंड सडन प्रोवोकेशन फ्रॉम जेड intentionally causes the death of Y, who is the brother of Z. X has committed offense of murder. Question number 123. R versus Diddley and Stephens is a case related with necessity. Yes, this is the correct. State versus KM Nanavati is a case related with murder on grave and sudden provocation. This was also correct. So in question number 123, correct option will be both 1 and 2 are true. Question number 124. R versus McNaughton is a case related with insanity as a defense. Yes, this is correct. And R versus Govinda is a case related with common intention. No, this is not the correct answer. So only here the option A is right answer. That is one is true and second is false. Question number 125. In which one of the following section of IPC, kidnapping or maiming a minor for begging has been discussed? This section is section 6363A. In this section of IPC, kidnapping or maiming of a minor for begging has been discussed. Question number 126. A is at a work with hatchet. The head flies off and kills a man who is standing nearby. A is guilty of murder. Culpable homicide not amounting to murder. Grievous hurt, no offense. Here, the correct answer is no offense. A will not be guilty of any offense. Question number 127. The maxim, actus me in vitro factus, non est mens acts, finds application section 94 of IPC. The maxim, ninimus non curat lex, has been incorporated in section 95 of IPC. Here, both the options are the correct answer. So option C will be the correct answer. Both 1 and 2 are true. Question number 128. A, having insured his shop, voluntarily causes fire to his shop, intending to realize insured money from insurance company. A has committed mischief. Question number 129. Which of the following is not matched correctly under the IPC? Thug. Counterfeiting, section 231 of IPC, this is the correct match. Bribery, section 171B, this we have already discussed in this paper only. Gender, section 8. So thug, section 309 is not the correct answer. Thug is provided in section 310 of IPC. Therefore, the A will be the correct answer because here it has been asked which of the following is not matched correctly. Question number 130. Which one of the following is a continuing offense? Abduction is a continuing offense. Question number 131. How many kinds of hurts are grievous hurt under section 320 of IPC? Correct answer is option C, that is 8. Question number 132. There is either theft or extortion in robbery. The offense of theft becomes robbery when it is coupled with danger to life. Here the option C is the correct answer. Both 1 and 2 are true. This is also correct answer and this is also correct answer. So option C will be the right answer. Question number 133. A distributes a compact disc to B, a young boy of 19 years, for seeing obscene pictures of recreation. A has committed an offense under which of the following section of IPC? Options are section 292, section 293, section 294, section 295. A has committed the offense under section 293 of IPC. Question number 134. A, by falsely pretending to be in civil services, intentionally deceives Z and does dishonestly induces Z to let him to have on credit goods for which he does not mean to pay. A has committed cheating. Question number 135. Section 304B and section 498A of IPC are mutually inclusive, not mutually inclusive, used only by Supreme Court, not to be used generally. Correct answer is not mutually inclusive. Question number 136. Z is carried off by a tiger. A fires at the tiger knowing it to be likely that the shot may kill Z, but not intending to kill Z, and in good faith, intending to Z's benefit, A's bullet gives Z a mortal wound. A will not be guilty of any offense because he has no mens rea to kill A. Question number 137. Indian courts have jurisdiction to try a crime committed by an Indian in a foreign country. Indian courts do not have jurisdiction to try a crime committed by a foreigner in India. Second statement is not correct. First statement is true and second statement is false. Therefore, the option A will be the correct option. Question number 138. A sought to appear at the BA examination on the basis of forged mark sheet of intermediate, but forged mark sheet was detected before the commencement of the examination. A will be guilty of attempt to cheat. A will be guilty of attempt to cheat. Question number 139. Any such fact which possesses probative force is called evidence. This definition belongs to Salmond. Salmond has given this definition that any such fact which possesses probative force is called evidence. Question number 140. When two or more persons fight in a public place and commit breach of peace, they commit affray. Affray can only occur in public places and only two persons are required to commit affray, whereas riot can be committed at the private place only, and in riot minimum 5% is to be required. Question number 141. In which of the following offense guilty intention is not an essential element? Option here the correct answer is bigamy. In bigamy, the mens rea is not required. In other options, that is murder, robbery, theft, the guilty intention, that is mens rea, is relevant. Question number 142. Which one of the following section of IPC provide for solitary confinement for a convict? Correct answer is section 73. Section 73 of IPC talks about a solitary confinement. Question number 143. Which section of IPC provides for the imprisonment for non-payment of fine when the offence is punishable with fine only? Options are section 63, section 64, section 67, none of the above. Here the correct answer is option C, that is section 67. Section 67 of IPC provides for the imprisonment for non-payment of fine when the offence is punishable with fine only. Question number 144. A intentionally pulls up a woman's veil in order to annoy her. A commits criminal force. This is an illustration prescribed in the IPC Act of in the section of criminal force. A intentionally pulls up a woman's veil in order to annoy her. A commits criminal force. Question number 145. Robbery is dacoity when the minimum number of persons committing robbery is 10, 5, 6, 4. Correct answer is 5 persons. Robbery is dacoity when the minimum number of persons committing robbery is 5 persons. Question number 146. A finds a ring lying on the high road, not in the possession of any persons. He keeps it himself. A has committed theft, criminal misappropriation, criminal breach of trust, none of the above. Correct answer is criminal misappropriation. Question number 147. In which of the following cases recently the Supreme Court has upheld the constitutional validity of a criminal statute in offenses against the order of nature? Options are National Legal Service Authority versus Union of India, Charu Khurana versus Union of India, Jaya Bahaduri versus Union of India, Suresh Kumar Kaushal versus Nas Foundation. Correct answer is Suresh Kumar Kaushal versus Nas Foundation. This talks about the section 377 of IPC, and you can also read about the Navtej Singh Johar versus Union of India relating to this question only. Question number 148. Shatrughan Chauhan versus of Union of India 2014 is the case related to giving false evidence before the court waging war against the state, commutation of death sentence of life imprisonment. C, that is commutation of death sentence to life imprisonment, is the correct answer. In Shatrughan Chauhan versus Union of India, this case was related to commutation of death sentence to life imprisonment. Question number 149. A claiming to be a family planning expert gave X some chemical. After consuming chemical, the child in the womb of X die in the womb. A has committed no offense, offense of murder, offense of culpable homicide not amounting to murder, offense of causing miscarriage. Correct answer is offense of causing miscarriage is the correct answer. Question number 150. A cuts down a tree on B's land with the intention of dishonestly taking the tree out of B's possession without B's consent. A has committed the offense of theft. So here we will end this question paper, previous year's question paper of UP APO 2015. Other previous question papers are also in lineup. Please join our Telegram group and also subscribe to our YouTube channel. And thank you for watching. Thank you so much.